Hello everyone, in this tutorial I'm going to make a low polygonal still life. I usually start building a mesh with the point topology tool. It is better to switch to orthographic projection. This button is in the viewport panel. You can assign hotkey for these purposes. For example, I set the combination of shift plus space. You can simply hold down the Shift key and double click to select all the faces. Use Ctrl plus G or Escape to deselect. You can turn on the global space axis to navigate where the object is located. To set the object exactly to the center of the workspace, you can simply set the coordinates to 0. Now let's use the radial symmetry. To do this, choose the symmetry panel and choose the radial symmetry mode. You can also assign a number of segments, but I will use 4 segments. To apply symmetry, you need to choose Apply symmetry to current layer, which can be found in the mesh panel. Then make sure you can turn off the symmetry. To do that, you can simply press the Reset symmetry button. To select the entire object in the layer, you can simply use the button geared one from the left. Next to it, you can also find a button for duplicate the object. With this button, you can duplicate the entire current layer. When holding down the Ctrl key, you can rotate by clicking. This makes it easier to rotate an object by exactly 45 degrees. You can also change the style of how the object looks. The fact is that the current style is better suited for a topology. For example, you can turn off the UV islands. This mod is better suited for modeling. will continue to clone. If we move on like this, we then should get a spikelet of wheat. Now I will make a stalk. For this purpose I will again use the point to poly tool. But this time I want to draw your attention to this tab. You see that the Ctrl plus Shift is written here, which means that holding down this case will make a different tool work. You can see that the Edge Split tool is now selected. So when I hold down those keys, it works like Edge Split. You can choose another tool, for example, Quads tool. You can see when I hold down the Ctrl plus Shift, then it works as a Quads tool. This way you can do many different tasks without switching from the point to poly tool. To make the leaf go in a separate layer, I use the separate tool. You can see how it appeared in the new layer now. I'm using the simplest method for smoothing. It is the smooth tool. You can see the leaves look rounded now. The easiest way to round the stem is to use the smooth tool. I'm just added segments close to the edge to keep the corners at the edge sharp. You can see that the edge remains sharp because I'm added a segment here. If you want to merge the layers, hold on the Shift key and drag to another layer. You can now use the brush tool to complete the look. Let's add the finished object to the poly model panel. In the future, we will use them as spare parts to create scenes. In the next videos, I'll show how the subsequent objects get created. So, until next time, then, and see you.